good evening, everyone. I'm glad you decided to pop by and join me for this new video. To get started, I'm going to do my channel naming. And the channel that I will be naming is ASMR Glow. And I chose this channel because of the video that she did with Cleopatra, which is the same theme as my video today. So, if you would like to go and visit ASMR Glow's channel, the link is down in the description. Today's video, obviously, is a roleplay of Cleopatra. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy. Hello, Imhotep, my friend. Thank you for accepting my summons. Please, come, sit down. Take a seat. Can I offer you some refreshments? Okay. Yes, they're very pretty, aren't they? These are family heirlooms. They were passed down to me. For my family. And I just love the sound that they make. I really find it relaxing. Anyway, those refreshments, let's have a little drink. There for you. Little toast. Yes, I like to do it more than once. I think it brings luck. Bottoms up. Vintage, yes, from my very own winemakers. I hope you enjoy it. It's very sweet, isn't it? I find this beverage to be very relaxing after a hard day's ruling over the kingdom. I like to sit back and enjoy a nice goblet of wine. you're my most prized architect. And I would just like to tell you that I am very happy with the advancements that you're making with my monuments, my temples. On that topic, how are they coming along? How is the construction coming? Are there any problems with the workers? Well, obviously it is very tiring, and sometimes there can be some little accidents that can occur during construction, and that's perfectly normal. But I hope that you're making sure that the workers, injured workers are taken care of. Don't put them straight back to work, they need time to recover. And I'm sure we can find replacements for them, no problem. So, are the quarters that I provided for you and your family, are they comfortable? Are they good for you? Is your family happy there? Yes, I know. I was very generous to allow you to live within the palace. But I think that that's normal. You're one of my most prized helpers. You're a very famous architect, so as such I treat you with great respect and give you the gifts that you merit. Yes, you're doing a wonderful job. I haven't been down there myself in the last few days, but my co-workers, if we can call them that, because I'm obviously, you know, their superior, because I'm the queen. But yeah, they tell me that it's coming along very well, that your progression is advancing quite speedily, and that's what I like. And how about the fleet of boats? How is that coming along? Because you know we're going to need them very soon for our conquests, our upcoming conquests that we've got coming. I'm going to need them. So, yeah, they're coming along good. Wow, there's only a year left for them to be finished. That's amazing. You must be sorcery, you must work magic to accomplish these things in such short time periods. I'm not going to ask you how you do it. I know that magicians have their secrets. I'm just glad that everything is coming along so well. Yes, you are making your queen very happy. Why don't we have another toast to celebrate the accomplishment that you have surpassed with flying colours. It's well deserved after all. To your work, the magnificent work that you're doing with my temples. Here's to you. And to everlasting, immortal life in the afterlife. You know, being the daughter of Isis comes with great responsibilities. And who says great responsibilities says a lot of stress. I'm under great pressure to run this kingdom accordingly and to live up to my predecessors. Sometimes it's a little bit too much for me. somehow I manage. I don't know how I do it, but I manage. I think a lot of it is about taking one day at a time, one step at a time. And also having so many people around me to help me through ruling the kingdom correctly, it helps a lot, and you are one of those people. So I thank you dearly for the help that you have brought me. Ask you something. Do you feel as though you have too much work as an architect? No? Wow. How would you like a promotion? Well, what I had in mind is my vizier is getting very old, and his healers tell me that he hasn't got much time left. He's sick, and although I adore the man and he has been a great help to me over my years of ruling, he is soon going to extinguish from this world. As you know, we will start the mummification process, and he will be given an adequate tomb. So that leaves me with the burden of finding a replacement. And as you've been so very good at your job and so very helpful in lots of different aspects, I was wondering if you would consider taking up the position. Of course, the position comes with a lot of responsibilities, but with that comes also all the riches that come with the post, and obviously the rank that comes with it. You will be paid very generously for this position, and I would be in great debt towards you, because without a vizier, it would be very difficult for me. It would be too much for one person to rule the whole kingdom all on their own. You know, pharaohs have always been surrounded by their viziers and their staff. So, suffice it to say that I need to start thinking about his replacement now. I know that sounds very macabre because he is still with us, but his healers assure me that this will not be for very much longer. And as ruler, I have to keep my kingdom's well-being in mind, so having the knowledge that my vizier will soon pass, I have to start thinking about finding someone to take his place. So, I offer it to you, who has been my loyal architect for so many years now, also to my father. before me. So I think that you are the one for this position. Do you accept? Thank you, Imhotep. Believe me, you will not regret it. And you will be bestowed with so many riches. Your family will never go hungry again. And they will always have what they need. Your wife will be provided with all the food she needs to feed your family. Your children will be educated by my personal teachers that I had when I was young. They will be taught in the arts of medicine and history and everything else, languages, astronomy. They will receive everything that they will need to grow up, and in their turn, once arrived at the age of adulthood, they will be given positions that will fit their respective talents and competences. I am very glad that you accept this offer that I'm giving you, this opportunity. It is going to be a very big help to me. And as you know, the vizier has the possibility, when the pharaoh in power at the time passes, they have the possibility of having a claim to the throne. Has been known in past dynasties that the pharaoh's vizier has become pharaoh in turn because the pharaoh in question did not have any children to pass the throne to. Now, of course, as you know, I do have my own children. Caesarian and the twins, but in the times that we're living in, we never know what's going to happen. People are taken so easily by illness, and so we never can tell who is going to live into adulthood and who isn't. I do not wish this to happen to my children, obviously, but as ruler, I must keep an open mind and think of all the possibilities, the possible outcomes. So, if for whatever reason my children don't live to adulthood, as my vizier, you will have a claim to the throne. Does this make you happy? Is that something that you would want? To climb onto the throne of Egypt? Well, I don't suppose that is something you would think about when you're not royal born, I suppose. But you're going to have time to think about it now. Obviously, this offer does not take effect right away, because my vizier is still alive. But when his time comes and he passes over to the other side, and once the mummification is completed and the funeral has taken place, then you will enter into your function. Another toast to your future position as a royal vizier. Bottoms up. This wine is so delicious. And when you become a vizier, you will have access to all of this delicious wine, all my supplies of wines. We will become very close friends, and believe me, I spoil my friends. I invite you to have your own personal scribe. Take note of all of this, so the history books won't forget that Imhotep became vizier to Cleopatra VII. Yes, I think it's important that history remembers events that come to pass. It's important to remember history so that we don't repeat the mistakes that have been made. Would you like some more wine? You like this, do you? Yes, well, as I said before, it's a family heirloom. Passed down to me from generation to generation, all the way back to my ancestor. I guess it must have been Ptolemy the First, I guess. Maybe even Alexander the Great, I'm not actually quite sure which of my ancestors this came from. I absolutely adore this set of goblets and jug. like to thank you for accepting this offer that I've presented you with. It's obviously a big opportunity for you to evolve your career.
It's also going to be a very great help to me
when my present vizier passes away. If I hadn't have found someone, that would be very, very damaging for the kingdom, for a pharaoh to rule alone without any side help is not good. It has happened in the past that pharaohs have found themselves alone to take care of the whole kingdom, but it has never usually turned out well when this has been the case. It's just too much of a burden for one person, so we must share these burdens to make them less heavy on one person's shoulders. So, thank you for accepting. So, for the time being, you will resume your present occupation as architect and overseer of the construction of my monuments. But when you become vizier, obviously, you will no longer be allowed to do that activity, because your full attention will be required for your vizier position. I will find a different architect. Believe me, they line up on their own. Which is not the case for the position of vizier. It's a lot more difficult to fill that position. I guess maybe the responsibilities put people off. And also, I have to choose someone that I trust completely. So that's why I'm so very glad that you accepted my offer. Yes, I understand that you have to go, because you have to oversee my constructions. You take good care of building, overseeing the building of my temple, especially my temple. I want that to be perfect. Yeah. So, go oversee the construction. And if you need anything, whatever it is, anything at all, just don't hesitate to come and ask me personally. Yes, you can tell my guards to let you through. Actually, I'll tell them that they can let you through anytime you need anything. Come and see me personally, and I will see what I can do to give you what you need. I want my future vizier to have everything he needs, and to be very comfortable while he's doing it. You may take your leave now. Thank you for coming and seeing me. Thank you for accepting my summons. And thank you for accepting my offer. Okay. Have a good day. Who has watched this video in full? If anyone, in fact, gets to this part of the video, which I seriously doubt. I don't think anyone watches my videos fully to the end, except me. But anyway, to you who has maybe gotten to the end of this video, I would
would like to thank you for coming and watching my video and joining me tonight to watch my video. So thank you. And I would like to remind you that the link to the channel that I named in the beginning of the video is down in the description. And also down in the description you will find my Facebook account for my channel, my channel's Facebook account, my channel's Instagram account. And yeah, that's it. So if you want to go and check any of those out, please don't hesitate. I would be happy to receive your visit. Also, I accept all invitations and follows on both of those social media platforms. So don't hesitate if you want to maybe add me to your friends list. You can. It is allowed. Anyway, thanks for watching. By the way, this isn't wine. This is just water. And I said wine in the video because that's one of the drinks that they had back in ancient Egypt, along with beer. I think those were the two very omnipresent drinks that they had access to, along with water, but I don't think many ancient Egyptians drank water from the history stuff that I've read and documentaries that I've watched. So I said wine. But it's not actually wine. I can't even prove it to you. This is heavier than it looks. See? Oof. Sorry, I can't do that. I hope that you also got a good view on the fact that it is just water. I'm not drinking alcohol on YouTube. It's just water. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. Don't hesitate to go and have a little look on my Facebook account, Instagram account, where you can add me in your friends list, and you can even write to me if you want. You can send me a message. I generally answer everyone. Because I'm still a small channel, I'm still able to answer everyone. See you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. And sleep well.